Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Wednesday, November 16th. It is a little cold out there this morning, and we do have some rain that is falling across the Garden State, but our chief meteorologist, Dan Zarrow, says the final raindrops will fall around 7, 8, 9 o'clock this morning, and then we will start to dry out. Now, the good news is we don't really have any more rain in the forecast through the weekend, but temperatures are going to remain cool. Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. State wildlife officials have set the start of December's bear hunt for the 5th of December. If not enough bear are killed in the first 6 days, the hunt could be extended another 4 days. Governor Murphy long opposed a bear hunting reverse course and now supports it after a spike in bear-human encounters. Meanwhile, state officials and law enforcement are investigating the killing of 4 bear cubs in Ringwood. Now, the Bruins had been seen around town. Residents are upset over reports that the bear have been killed, but no further details have been made available. Former President Donald Trump has launched another bid for the White House, promising supporters he will make America great and glorious again. Trump made it official Tuesday night after teasing the potential of a comeback since before he even left the White House in 2021. He'd hoped to piggyback off expected Republican gains in last week's midterm elections and stave off potential challengers. Instead, Trump is facing blame for the party's underwhelming performance. New Jersey Congressman Jeff Van Drew, who switched parties to support Trump, among the first New Jersey elected Republicans who have endorsed Trump's second White House bid. No charges will be filed in what was investigated as a potential bias incident around the election in South Jersey. Police say they found the woman caught on video hanging dolls in rope nooses above a sign for Tim Alexander on election day. Family members say the 36-year-old female from Rio Grande had been dealing with behavioral health issues. Alexander, a former law enforcement officer, was briefed on the outcome. He was said to agree with no charges being filed. He ran an unsuccessful bid for Congress. The search has been called off this morning for a hiker missing in North Jersey. Crews had been searching the Ramapo River for 41-year-old Hector Zamorano. He never returned home on Sunday. Family reported him missing. Rescuers also had combed through about a 4,000-acre county park. There have been no signs of the missing hiker. If you shop at the ShopRite in Shrewsbury and you noticed a creeper following you through the store last month, you may want to give police a call. Officers have arrested 33-year-old Red Bank man Christopher Cox for taking photos of at least 2 women on October 20th. Cox fled the store in an SUV, which police located about a week later. NJ.com reports he fled that stop and was not taken into custody until about a week later. Gas prices did drop again overnight, a little bit, about a penny a gallon. The latest numbers from AAA put the statewide average at $3.88 a gallon for regular. All counties are averaging below $4, the most expensive gas still being found in Somerset, Middlesex, Hunterdon, and Ocean counties. This morning prices are about 7 cents lower than a week ago, but still higher than the national average of $3.77. Adult spotted lantern flies were terrorizing almost every corner of New Jersey, even down the shore during the summer. They are starting to die off, but not before they lay their eggs. And this is the time for you to go out and hunt those eggs, according to officials, so you can destroy them and they don't hatch in the spring. They're only about an inch in size. Fresh ones look like they're covered with gray mud. Older masses are tan. They resemble cracked mud. The New Jersey Department of Agriculture says you can do your part by scraping off the egg masses and press against them so you can actually hear the eggs popping. We have more on this morning from Ardino Flamia at nj1015.com. Large churches and public venues in New Jersey are going to be required to put together an action plan to deal with a terror attack or a mass shooting event. Governor Murphy has signed into legislation. The gun violence is an epidemic, he says. Having plans in place will enhance police response. Any house of worship that seats 500 or more, movie theaters that seat at least 1,000, sports and entertainment venues with a capacity of at least 5,000 will have to develop a response plan and submit it to the state for review. You will soon be able to fly to the West Coast from Atlantic City International Airport. The South Jersey Transportation Authority confirms Sun Country Airlines will begin offering flights from ACY starting in May. The flight to Sun Country's Minneapolis-St. Paul hub will offer connections to multiple destinations. Currently, only Spirit Airlines flies out of Atlantic City to Florida, South Carolina, and Puerto Rico. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Wednesday, November 16th. Have a great day.